Hi there, welcome to another video from Hegarty Maths. It's Mr. Hegarty here. It's another video on straight line graphs, but this time I'm going to give you an alternative way to define them. So let's start with the way we've already defined them and what we already know. Previously on Hegarty Maths, I have shown you equations of straight lines in the form y equals mx plus c, where m is the gradient and c indicates the y-intercept. So if I asked you to draw something like this, pause the video and double check you could. Well, here the gradient is 2 and the y-intercept, because that number is 4 here, is going to be at 0, 4. So what we usually do is we go to 0, 4 and using the gradient of 2 we go to the right one and we go up 2, we go to the right one, we go up 2, and that gives us enough points there to draw our straight line, which would be something like that, just extending that. And we label it and equal to y equals 2x add 4. Okay? And that's how we've defined straight lines previously in this particular form. The purpose of this skill is to actually show you another way of defining a straight line that sometimes is even more useful for us. Now, just before I show you the other way of defining a straight line, I want to check you can answer questions like this. We've done this previously. Pause the video, double check you can do that. Well, we answered questions like this using y equals mx plus c form. You state y equals mx plus c, you're told the gradient is 4, m is 4. You're told a point that the line goes through, so you substitute in y is 3 and x is 2 into your equation of a straight line, find c, and then you can state your equation of a line. The technique I'm going to show you is going to help us answer questions like this even a tiny little bit more easily, and it's also just worth knowing because it's interesting. Alright, how are we going to define a straight line in an alternative way? Well, in the way we know, what did we need before? We needed a gradient told to us, so say we were told the gradient was, I don't know, 2, and we needed the y-intercept. They were the two facts we know. Say we were told it was on 0, 3. So we'd go up to 0, 3, and we'd count up gradients. We'd go 1 across, 2 up, 1 across, 2 up, 1 across, 2 up, and that would give us our straight line. Kind of like this. Okay, that was the old way. Now, suppose instead I wasn't given the y-intercept, but suppose I was given the gradient, suppose I was told, I don't know, the gradient is 2, but I was told a point on the line. Say if I was told a point on the line was 4, 3, that was definitely on the line. What I could do is I could think of defining the straight line. I start over at 4, 3, kind of like how I started with the y-intercept. And I'm going to say it's the set of points that are that I can count using a gradient of 2 away from 4, 3. I can, using gradient of 2, I can go 1 across, I can go 2 up, I can go 1 across, I can go 2 up, I can go 1 across and 2 up, I can go 1 back and 2 down, etc. And that there would define for me a straight line in a different way. Okay, it would define a straight line with a gradient and a given point. So that's a kind of a new or alternative way. And the way I'm going to formalize this, I'm going to say that in the new way, it's the set of points, it's all the x and y's, so all the x and y's, such that from the given point that I'm told about the line, which I'm going to call x1, y1, that's a particular point I'm given on the line, it's all the x and y's that satisfy this equation. Y, take away that y1 point, over x, take away x1, always gives me the answer 2. So it's the set of points, x and y, such that y take away this y1 point, the point I know on the line, divided by x take away this x1 point, the point I know on the line, always give me a gradient of 2. So it's very like the old way, it's just it goes through any particular point. And I can rearrange this equation as follows. I can multiply both sides by x subtract x1, so I could say mx subtract x1 is equal to y subtract y1. And we usually write the y's on the left hand side, so I'm going to just write this as y subtract y1 equals mx subtract x1. And that's an alternative way, an alternative formula for a straight line. Now, when's it useful? It's really useful for us when we are given the gradient and a point on the line. It stops us having to find c and do some extra algebra. So we could use this equation here in order to find that find those answers really quickly. And now I'm going to work through some questions we already know how to do using y equals mx plus c, but now using y subtract y1 is m brackets x subtract x1 to show you its power and how it's a lot quicker in some cases. So let's try the one we already started the video with, this very question. Pause the video and have a go if you think you can do it. Well, here we're told everything we need. We're given a point that the line goes through and a gradient. The gradient is equal to 4. So we know we can define the line in a new way, y subtract y1 is equal to m x subtract x1. I know the gradient is 4, so I know m is 4, and I know that the point that the line goes through is 2, 3. So putting them straight in here, I can say y subtract 3 is equal to 4 x bracket 2. Multiply out that bracket, y subtract 3 is therefore 4x take away 8, add 3 to both sides, y is equal to 4x subtract 5. Done. Super quickly and super fast. Now you'll notice if I go back, that was the same as what we got previously. Can you see that? We got that answer previously, but this time we got it much quicker, I think. So it was a really powerful method. Let's try another one. Pause the video, have a go yourself. Okay, here we're given a point that the line passes through, we're given a gradient, and we're told, just be careful here, we must leave our answer in the form ax, sum lots of x plus sum lots of y equals a number where a, b and c are integers, so we've got to be careful there. So state our formula, y subtract y1 is equal to m x subtract x1. I'm going to use this because I've got a point and a gradient. So therefore y subtract 5 is going to equal a third x subtract negative 2. So y subtract 5 is going to equal a third x add 2. Now I want to get rid of fractions because I'm told to leave my answer with a, b and c integers. So I'm going to multiply both sides of this equation by 3. And that gives me on this side, that's going to give me 3y subtract 15, multiplying out that bracket. 3 times a third just gets rid of that, I get x add 2. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to add 15 to both sides and I'm going to subtract x from both sides. Okay. And what will that leave me with? Well, it will leave me with negative x add 3y is going to equal to 17. And a in this case is equal to negative 1, b in this case is equal to positive 3, and c in this case is equal to 17. There's no harm, I would be allowed to multiply both sides by negative 1 if I really wanted to, and I would have x subtract 3y is equal to negative 17. In this case, a would be positive 1, b would be negative 3, and c would be negative 17. Both of these are equivalent to each other, so it doesn't matter which one you write. And there we go, we're done. And let's have a go at this one finally. Right, this one's going to call on a lot of our knowledge. Find the equation of a line perpendicular to this line, and that line passes through a negative 4, 3. Leave our answer in this form here. Right, firstly, if we want it to be perpendicular to this line, it must have a gradient, the negative reciprocal of 5, which is negative a fifth. So m is going to equal negative a fifth. Next, we know the point through the line. So we can use our formula y subtract y1 equals m x subtract x1 because we've got a gradient, we've got a point. So we're going to say y subtract 3 is going to equal negative a fifth x subtract negative 4. So y take away 3 is going to be negative 1 fifth x add 4. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to multiply both sides by 5, okay, to get rid of that fifth here, okay. So therefore on this side I'm going to get 5y subtract 15. 5 times negative a fifth is just negative 1, and I have x add 4. That's really like a negative 1. So I'm going to multiply out that bracket as well. I'm going to get 5y subtract 15 is equal to negative x subtract 4. And I want the x's and the y's and the numbers now maybe on the left hand side, So what I'm going to do is I'm going to add x to both sides. I'm going to add 4 to both sides. I'm going to add 4 there and add the x there. And what will I get myself? Well, I'm going to get myself x, add 5y. Negative 15 add 4 is negative 11 is equal to 0. Here my a is 1, my b is equal to 5, and my c is equal to negative 11. And there you go, I have found an equation of a line perpendicular to the y equals 5x subtract 2, passing through the point negative 4, 3, and in the form ax plus by plus c equals 0, where a, b, and c are integers. And we're done. And that was a useful way and a useful little technique to help us answer these questions quicker. Thanks for watching.